Hey guys, Mike here, One Go Short Play. Playing Chester Cheetah, Wild Wild Quest. And right on cue, here comes my cat Topsy, onto my desk for a cuddle. Let's get you out of the way. Yes, that's a good idea. Oh, she's kicking stuff around now. He was cruising on his Cheetah-mobile. Graphically, yeah, this looks better already. So I'm guessing this was a follow-up to the last one. Yeah, this is looking pretty cool. Okay. I can't actually see where we... Ah, it's a little orange paw. All right, we'll start there. Let's go. Oh, my hog. Oh, I thought it was going to be like... For some reason, I had Road Rash in mind then. That's much better looking than the previous one. And it's much more definitely a platformer. Yeah, it's much more within the constraints of a platformer. What is going on there? There's stuff up there. Oh, right, I see, okay. One hit, instant death. He came down on me, didn't he? Quite literally. Oh, wow. All right, okay. looks gorgeous. Visually very, especially this stuff here, very reminiscent of Robocod. The way these walls in the background are, I think. Now, can't go in there. Can't go in there. Very, very slow, though. I mean, I know he's going uphill. I don't know. There's something about it, though, that isn't right. It doesn't feel right. I mean, it's very, very floaty for a start. Graphics are gorgeous, but it's very floaty to play. But it's not that. There's something else that isn't right about this game. He's eating some Cheetos. He's all right now. They weren't really that much like water to me. What the hell is going on with that guy? He's standing in the middle of the water. Yeah, there's something not right about this game. I can't put my finger on it yet. Something about the logic of the challenges in it. Oh god, it's so floaty. Get out of the water. And just that, he's in the water, apparently. And you have to tap it to get out. It's like, you know, it's like the design document says this is the rule. And then the game's, the implementation of the game, while it's kind of literal, it's not, that, for example, when he, design document might say when he hits water he sinks, and then to get out of the water you tap like that, tap jump. Now that would make sense, but the design document might also mention that get away, that it has a splash effect when you hit the water. It's all there, but the implementation is pretty shoddy. The graphics are good, it's just the way that composited together, you know, isn't. Like that splash effect could have come from a different game. It's only the fact that it's in a purple colour that matches the water, purple water, and that makes it match the water. What? That's weird. That appeared at my head. See what I mean? And there's no sense that you're in the water apart from the slow movement. You just get like bubbles in the foreground of you, or you just get your character to go into like a floaty swim mode or something, you know? But it's like they haven't provided those animations because, you know, it's not being asked for in the design document. And there's something about the jumps as well. I keep hitting jump to jump over them. Oh, well, this sucks. This is rubbish, actually. This is actual rubbish. I'd say the jumps happen about 50% of the time you press it. The jump itself is right. You've got that thing where you can tap it or you can hold it and you go a bit higher. That's fine, that's all good. So some of the mechanics in this game are really well done. The graphics are very well done indeed. Just things like that. I've seen it about 10 times now. And I still can't get my head around how he works. What is he even doing? He's picking up hay bales and throwing them. He's standing in the middle of the water, waist height in the water. His feet are flat, like they should be on a floor. What's going on with that? It makes no sense. So it leaves the player kind of confounded as to what the hell is going on. How did I die then? Yeah, this is utter rubbish. Shame, because the graphics are gorgeous. What a waste of a good artist. The graphics are gorgeous, much better than the last Chester Cheetah game. The game is terrible. Oh look, you can run, but I wouldn't dare use it because, let's face it, everything is instant death. And the scale of those guys didn't really work, did it? Is he a human? Because he's like a little mini beast human. I think you can jump on the heads, but who'd take the chance when contact is instant death? And as the last level proved, even jumping on the heads doesn't guarantee killing them without dying. This is a very sucky game. A very sucky game. The way in which enemies collide with you. Oh, it's cornered there. It looks like you get to a certain point and you eat your Cheetos and then you're alright. So you get like an extra life out of them. Oh, it's such a shame because the graphics are so nice. So competently done. Really? But the game design is just a disgrace. Oh, there's my Cheetos. There's my extra life. We mustn't forget that this, at the end of the day, is just an advert for crisps. So the message here is, eat your Cheetos and you get another life. In life. There you go, look. That was utter rubbish, that enemy, though. Utterly impossible to avoid. Nothing fun about this game. It's really dull. Don't forget the map. Oh, as if I can be bothered with the map. Is that the map? Precariously placed by that crab's claw. There you go. Happy, satisfied, like your graphics. You are a terrible, terrible game, though. Oh, I want to play a good game now. Congratulations, special bonus of no bonus. Who cares? It's not as though I'm invested. Uh-oh. Is this level boss? Cool, level boss. No, don't jump. Run. Do jumps. Oh, okay. I'm going to call that a day there because I've had enough. Chester Cheetah, the other one. Wild Wild Quest, that's the one. Thanks for watching.